NASA has discovered two new likely habitable planets, and one of them has three red suns. The best part about these new planets, other than the fact that they probably have aliens on them that we can hug, they're really close by. What is Gravy You Potatoes? This is IO, where we make the news more entertaining, and I'm Charlotte, and I hope you are having a fantastic weekend so far. And if you're not, this next story will definitely make your day better. If you haven't subscribed yet, just like do it already, cause like I know you think I'm cute. Like I'm a solid like 7 out of 10, and my love of aliens and sense of humor easily makes me like an 8. Chill out, I was making a joke. Sheesh. All right, enough chit chat, let's get into this video. So, imagine looking up at the sky and seeing not one, not two, but three bright red suns. That would definitely be dope. Hot, but dope. Using a massive space telescope, NASA's Transiting Exoplanet Survey Satellite, or TESS for short, scientists discovered an exoplanet with three red suns, called M-dwarfs, just 22.5 light years from Earth. Scientists have called this exoplanet LTT-1445AB. That's boring. Why do scientists always name exoplanets such boring names? I am the Potato Queen and I say that this planet shall hereby be referred to as Planet Potato. For the rest of this video, because I really don't want to read out all those letters and numbers on the teleprompter. Planet Potato orbits one of the three stars, all of which are red dwarfs shining out the last bit of their lives. If you're standing on the surface of Planet Potato, there's three suns, but two of them are far away and small. That's according to co-author Jennifer Winters, astronomer at the Harvard Smithsonian Center for Astrophysics. The huge first sun rises, and then the next one, smaller and further away, and then another third distant sun rises. The other two stars are about 100 times brighter than Venus and about the same size in the sky. Scientists also believe that Planet Potato is rocky, a third larger than the Earth and 8 times as massive. The average surface temperature of Planet Potato is 320 degrees Fahrenheit, or 160 degrees Celsius. It's a baked potato. And it circles one of the three stars every 5 days. Cool, right? But wait, it gets cooler. The thing that makes Planet Potato even more interesting to scientists is its atmosphere. Scientists don't know if it has an atmosphere yet. It might be way too hot. M-dwarfs go through a period where they are young, where they emit a lot of radiation, but this newly discovered planet is the best chance we have at finding life, and because the suns and the planet are arranged in a certain way, you know what, here's a quote, because like I can't explain it properly, I'll just let a scientist do it. Winters said, we don't know if planets' atmospheres are able to survive the high radiation of environment of an M-dwarf when it's really young. So this is going to be an amazing opportunity to study that. She went on, as it passes in front of its host star, it's backlit by the light from its host star, and we can study the types of molecules that are in its atmosphere. So when you think about the types of harsh environments on Earth where life can survive, like for example, thermal vent microorganisms that can survive temperatures of up to 113 degrees Celsius, 160 degrees Celsius isn't that far off from that. And that's just the type of life that we are familiar with on Earth. Who knows what's possible in the universe? Do you think that there could be aliens on LTT-1445AB, aka Planet Potato? Let me know in the comments. For now, I'm gonna wrap up this video with some comment responses from my video. People are putting hair removal cream in shampoo bottles. Pirichi Tail said, I love my hair. If someone tampered with my shampoo and put nair in it, I would become Satan himself. Girl, preach. Otaniel Vasquez said, Potato Queen, if I don't bend the knee, will you turn me into a baked potato? Dude, only if you call me the Potato Queen one more time. Kay said, get a haircut, looking good girl. I did, thank you. Friday said, I love you IO for the funny news and good information. This is why I liked almost every video and subbed. Also hit the notification bell. Charlotte, how did you become the Potato Queen? Only people who like every video are privy to that information. That is it for me, thanks for watching. If you wanna keep watching, check out that playlist over there. Leave a like if you enjoyed this video, subscribe if you want more, and maybe I'll see you in a future IO video.